I welcome you all for Quality Tools Learning Together. I am thankful to all the viewers and subscribers for amazing response. Today we are going to discuss one of the interesting topics in quality. What is 80-20 rule? Agenda for discussion will be to understand what is 80-20 rule, when to use Pareto analysis, how to create a Pareto analysis. If you have any questions, please feel free to post them. I'll be glad to take them up. What is 80-20 rule? Popularly known as Pareto analysis. It states that 80% of the problems are due to 20% of the causes. Let us examine this with graphical representation. Let x-axis be the defect type, y-axis be number of occurrences, defect type 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, plotted along x and y. Let secondary axis be cumulative percentage. If you plot a cumulative curve and draw a parallel line to x-axis at 80%, the point where it intersects, draw a vertical line that approximately comes to 20%. The 20% of the causes are contributing to 80% of the problems. These are also known as vital causes, and rest of them are known as trivial causes. So let's take a case study and understand how to create them when you don't have any statistical softwares like Minitab or Statistica. 210 rejections are reported from one product line within last 30 days. This is the problem statement. There are 210 rejections. How do you know which are the causes for those rejections? How you are going to solve that problem? Let's look at step-by-step solutions in this case. First step is to categorize those problems into groups of similar nature. Arrange data in descending order. Calculate the cumulative data and calculate the cumulative percentage. Let's look at these categories here. Out of these 210 rejections, these are the defect types: coating defect, hole roundness, surface finish, scratches, bend in part, irregular thickness. And let us see how many of number of occurrences. These data are arranged in descending order, counting to total of 210 rejections. The third step is cumulative occurrences, and fourth one is percentage of cumulative occurrences. Let us see how these look when graphically represented. The defects along x-axis, that is coating defect, hole roundness, surface finish, scratches, bend in parts, irregular thickness, and number of defects along y-axis. The first one with 60 number of occurrences, coating defects, and 50 number of occurrences, hole roundness, 40 time part got rejected due to surface finish, 30 time parts got rejected due to scratches, and 20 times parts got rejected due to bend, and 10 times part got rejected due to irregular thickness. Let us see how 80-20 rule can be applied to identify vital causes in this. Let defect type be along x-axis and number of defects be along y-axis, and secondary axis gives you cumulative percentage. The cumulative percentage of first defect, coating defect, is 28.6, and second one is hole roundness. Third one is surface finish with 40 number of rejections. Fourth one is scratches with 30 number of rejections. 20 times is a bend in part, and 10 times part got rejected due to irregular thickness. Let us draw a parallel line at 80% and vertical line at the intersection. The vital causes are coating defects, hole roundness and surface finish. These three defects contributing to 80% of the problem. These are the focus areas that we need to focus and identify the root cause for these and fix them to see the drastic improvement. In this case, we did a Pareto analysis based on number of occurrences, but Pareto analysis can be done based on the impact, based on the cost, based on the importance of that quality characteristics for the success of that product. Next session, I am planning on what is failure mode effect analysis. I invite you to subscribe the channel, add wings to journey of learning. Thank you for your time.